Welcome to today's video on Minecraft Skyblock. Today, I show you guys the best crop for you to have on your island. Real quickly, a large percentage of viewers who watch my videos are not subscribed, so make sure to leave a like and subscribe down below. And that's pretty much it. Let's see what happens. Yes, guys, we are here back on dazzer.opledges.com. And real quick, if you guys are new here, make sure you guys check out the server. It's been so much fun. And OP Legends actually gave me a code here on the server that gives you guys a free citizen rank on the server. Yes, the citizen rank. So all you guys do is head to the store. The link is down below. Add the citizen rank to your cart, and then at checkout, just put in the code Dazzer, and you get the citizen rank completely for free on the server. But here we are on the server. As you can tell by the title, we're going to be taking a look at one of the most OP farms that you can have on the server. If you guys didn't know, this is kind of similar to farming contests. If you do slash comp on the server right here, it brings up the competitions. And these competitions are how you get trophies, and trophies are how you win IS top. And if you don't know what IS top is, it's basically the top islands on the server. And then if you're in the top five, you win PayPal money every single week. But the thing is, a lot of the competitions are farm based. So today I'm going to be showing you guys our farms and actually the best farm for making money on top of just participating in competitions. But real quickly, we actually do have an April monthly crate we're going to open up in today's video. I have a lot of spawners in my inventory right now, so hopefully our inventory doesn't get too filled up, but we're going to go ahead and open this here. We get 10 rewards from this. So let's see. I'm just going to go ahead and start opening this right now. Let's see what we could get. Hopefully we do get something good. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Okay, we got a banknote. Ooh, a really good pickaxe. Let's go. Another banknote right here. We got a ton of coins we're going to be able to use at the coin shop, which is huge. We also got blaze spawners. That's really nice. We can expand our farms. And then finally, our final reward, the best item you can give these. Let's see what we get. Let's go. Oh my gosh, we just got 5 triple blaze spawners right now. Oh, that's going to be huge. Our XP farm is going to be absolutely massive. Because right now, if we take a look, I have my slayer skill right now. And that's obviously what we use a lot of the spawners for, is to up our slayer skill. Our farming skill right now, if we take a look at it, we are currently farming 8. We have a 32% auto replant chance and then 1.25 times farming drops, and I need to get my farming level higher. But if you take a look at our slayer skill right now, we are currently slaying 5, which gives us 1% coin chance and 0.5% stack smash chance. So I'm gonna head over to the island right now. We are gonna place all these spawners real quick in our new XP farm, and I'll show you guys that. And then guys, I'm gonna show you our insane crop farm, show you how to make a ton of money with them. So yeah, let's head over there. Okay guys, so here we are at our island. It's insane. We've been working on so many different things right here. The island is coming together. And also guys, a real quickly way, if you guys want an easy way to make money on the server, if you head over to Warp Mine, you guys can mine the ores right here, just like I am. You can mine these ores. You get these things called mine shards. And then if you do IS Warp Dazzer YT, you head over straight to our island. And this player shop right here, you can actually sell these mine shards to us. Just click right here. It's a free 1,000 coins. It helps us out a ton on the server. So if you guys want, just come on the server, Warp Mine. You get a pickaxe at the beginning, especially if you get the free citizen rank. Use code Dazzer. You get a pickaxe. Mine a little and help us out. It's going to help us so much. So we pay you. You get some starter money on the server as well. It's perfect scenario. So I recommend you guys do it. But yeah, this is our island right now. As you can tell, we have a lot of crop farms right now. Like, if our island, like 99% of it are crop farms. You can definitely tell this is a high pixel island just from the amount of crop farms we have. But as you guys saw, we did just get a ton of XP spawners, so I'm just gonna go ahead and redeem our banknotes right here real quick, and then boom. Oh my gosh, we got so many spawners right now. This is gonna be so nice. These triple blazes, I don't even think we had these on the island yet, so I'm gonna start with just placing the blazes right here. Boom, enderman right there, and then the triple blazes, I'm just gonna put those right there. Okay, boom, I'm placing all the spawners right now. We're getting a ton of them placed. Boom. Okay, we have all the spawners placed right now. I have this really cool grind sword right here, so if we head over to where we are, where we're grinding, oh my gosh, yeah, we're getting so many more mobs right here. This is so sick. And basically all these mobs right here, when we grind them, we're getting coins. You guys see in the chat right now, we're getting grinding mobs and from our coins enchant. And if we do mob coin shop right here, we can buy a lot better gear, which is gonna be super nice. We're gonna be able to buy pet boxes, some vote keys, and robots. Which also reminds you guys, if we do slash robots right now, we can actually take a look at our robots. These have made us almost over $2 million already, so I'm gonna collect them all right now. We just made $2.6 million from robots just being on our island. So yeah, robots are super OP. Get yourself a robot. You can get them in the vote keys pretty frequently, I think, from my experience. So yeah, robots are super OP, and there's like more OP robots on the server, so I'm gonna be buying a ton of those. Actually, we have 23,000 coins right now. Actually, I can't even afford a robot yet. That's how OP they are. We still need to get like another 20,000 coins, but once we do that, we'll be chilling. But yeah, this is where I've been grinding my slayer level. This is where I've been trying to get it up. It's the best way. You guys can also come to the island if you want to get your levels up. You can do IS Warp Dazzer IT. You could sell to us like this person is, or you could grind at our farms just to get your guys' self a head start on your island. It's just so you can get some good items for your island when you start one on here. But you guys saw the video title today. We're gonna be taking a look at the best farms on the server. So right now we actually have a wheat farm right here. We have a potato farm right here. This farm's completely blank at the moment. And then all the way down here, we have another potato farm. And so far from our experience, pretty much the islands and the competitions have primarily been potato contests and wheat contests. Like literally right here, if you look next competition's potato farmer, which is why we focus these two because they pretty much happen extremely frequently. So this right here is our basically massive potato farm. Now the only issue is right now we still are all getting our farming level higher, okay? Because obviously the skills are player based. It's not island based or anything. And if you take a look at my skills for someone like me, my farming skill, like I only have a 32% auto replant chance, which is kind of difficult, where we have people on our island right now that are farming 16 and 18, where right now they're getting like 64% auto replant chance and 72%. It happens a lot more frequently. So like right there, like we just got an auto replant right there. That was really nice. But the issue is this is basically what we've been doing. Now, if we take a look at the potato farm right here, if we just actually go ahead and do sell hand, our one potato sells for $54, which is really, really good. Like one potato for $54. And if you build a massive, massive farm, it is not too hard to make that money back. Where one wheat, on the other hand, it sells for $24. So potatoes are selling for $30 more on the server, as well as it's easier for the potatoes to scale. You get more drops, as well as you don't have to deal with like seeds in your inventory. Because the biggest issue is when grinding wheat, I'll show you guys, for example, right now, when I grind wheat on a straight line, I'm going to get in my inventory, I'm going to get a ton of wheat and I'm going to get a ton of seeds, which overall is inefficient because if I go in and sell all, the wheat is the only thing that sells. You can't even sell the seed. Now, I technically could sell the seeds on AH. That's what a lot of people do. Because if you guys didn't know, the only way you can actually get seeds and potatoes on the server are doing slash pass. If you do slash pass right here, it opens up the battle pass. And the first challenge is actually how you get wheat seed. What you have to do is you have to basically create a cobblestone generator on your island and mine 250 cobblestone, which is really not difficult at all. And then it gives you a stack of seeds and then you could just continue building your farm. But obviously the really important one that is how we got potatoes is right here. Challenge number 5, you have to farm 35,000 wheat. And then once you do that, you get 64 potatoes. And see, the thing is that's actually a pretty big barrier. Now the thing is you technically could buy stuff on AH and you could make a deal for potatoes. Like there's potatoes right here, but like they're expensive. Potatoes are expensive. So you either have to go ahead and grind 35,000 wheat or potatoes. And then obviously in my opinion, I recommend just doing the wheat anyways. It gets you a good amount of starter cash at the beginning, like 35,000 wheat. That'll be plenty. You could probably buy some decent spawners and all that stuff just to get things going on your island, like XP farms, kind of similar to like, so what we have going on over here. It works really, really well. And then also like over here, like we have our IS level being built up. These blocks on our island essentially add this thing called IS level. If we take a look at our IS level right now, we're currently IS level 4,152. But yeah, by far right now, potatoes are basically our main money-making method. And it's basically the best way to farm. The only issue with it, sadly, is for someone like me, I'm not actually getting auto replant frequently and I just need to get my farming level higher. But you do notice that I am getting these lucky chances. They keep popping up in the chat right here. And those are enchanted potatoes. If I do sell hand on these right here, those sell for $66. So it's an extra $12 per potato. But overall, I mean, obviously your main potatoes selling for $54 is really, really good. And the auto replant is not bad. This is pretty much the best way to go ahead and grind it. I know another really popular way to grind it is doing every 2, just like I am right here. It's pretty frequent. What we like to do is we do these farms and then we usually will have someone follow, but you can pretty much get every single potato right here. You can basically hit all of them. You can do 2 at a time, just like I'm doing right now. This is the best way that we've been farming potatoes. It works really well. And especially in competitions, because the competitions are based on a certain amount of time right here. Right now, the competition is Skeleton Slayer. And so first place, that individual has grinded 32,500 skeletons. They will get 3 trophies if they win. So for potatoes, we have one person that can do it, because obviously it's one person that can pick up the potatoes. So boom, just like this, you guys see how it is. But yeah, the biggest issue holding someone like me back right now is I just need to get my farming skill higher. Though you see in the chat right above my hell right now, I basically get plus 1.25 farming XP for every potato I'm hitting. So I'm actually gaining levels pretty quick, but it is a little unfortunate and it does slow me down a little that I have to get this up. Now, if I were to actually go ahead and if we do slash skills right now, if I did do the battle pass and I grind the 35,000 wheat myself, I would have a much higher farming skill, obviously, which is why people on our island right now that got the 35,000 wheat farm have really, really high levels on our island. So I recommend, you know, you guys will probably be a lot higher level if you do the farming wheat, which I highly recommend you do. Then you can start getting potatoes, get these planted. And these are honestly one of the best money making methods on the server right now that you could actively do. Cause obviously like farms, you can build AFK farms and everything, but actual potato grinding, this is by far like one of the best money making methods you can do right now. So yeah, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to grind this out for like 5 minutes, see how much I can make. And I'll show you guys the outcome after that I do that. Okay guys, I just went ahead and did a few rows. And during that process, I already went ahead and upgraded my farming skill right there. We're actually getting really close to farming 10, which will put us at 40% replant chance. But another thing I forgot to mention is that you also get these things called essence while grinding farming. So each different type of skills you grind drop different essences, but while farming you get Stormtrooper and Jango Fett. So you do slash gem armor on the server right now. We can actually take a look at Stormtrooper and Jango Fett right here. And basically these armor pieces, like we could basically, if we get Stormtrooper, for example, if we get 500 Stormtrooper essence, right now we only have 10, we could get a helmet. And if if we get a full set, we get a 35% cell boost with our Stormtrooper armor. Where Jango Fett will actually get 50% cell boost, so obviously the Jango Fett is better. But again, another piece of armor that we're actually trying to get right now is the Thor and/or Iron Man set, because those do skills boost, and if we are able to get skills boosted, then that'll make it so much easier for us to rank up our farming level. It's kind of like a little skills hack here on the server, guys. In order to get a higher farming level, get like Iron Man or Thorn gear, and you'll be chilling. Now, right now, we do have a pair of Thor boots in here, so I'll show you guys like real quickly like how quick we can get it. But yeah, we basically just put all our essence in here, and as like an island, I recommend you guys just pretty much share everything, because it is really expensive to be able to do this. But the Thor boots, like, because we have a pair of Thor boots on now, we will now get a 5% skills boost. Like, without the Thor boots in our inventory, we get 1.25, if you see it right above my hoe. And if I put these on now, we get 1.312. So it adds up, especially over a long amount of time while you're grinding this for a while. The skills boost add a ton of extra into our, you know, skills grinding, which makes my life a lot easier. And it's really nice because you could also sell this essence if you want to, or you could trade it with players. Like, some people want the cell boost, while you might want the skills boost. And sometimes you can find some really good deals on boots on AH. This isn't super frequent, but you can find decent stuff here as well. But yeah, guys, so far, this is how much I made real quickly. It wasn't anything crazy, and the issue is I do have to plant. So I'd probably say about half of this I'm gonna have to replant. But overall, I mean, you could probably make with this farm with a cell booster and everything, which really isn't too difficult to get. You could also cap outposts and everything. We're looking at about $3 to $5 million every single hour from this money-making method, which is really, really good for how simple of a money-making method this is and how crucial it is, because you also could be winning contests with this money-making method and competitions. Like, that's trophies you get, which again go towards IS top right here. So yeah, I highly recommend you guys come check out the server, dazzer.oplegends.com. Get yourself building, start the slash pass, and start immediately going for the wheat seeds. Those are really, really easy to get. Again, like I said, all you have to do to get the wheat seeds is build a cobblestone generator and go ahead and get 250 cobble, which I think you guys could do really easily, and then you get the wheat seeds. Then you can go ahead and start your farm. And also, like I said at the intro, guys, it would really help us out as an island if you guys come onto the server, do warp mine. If you grind in the mine, the ores, and then sell the clusters to us, we're buying at 1,000 a piece. It's a great way to get starter money on the server, and we would really, really appreciate it. But yeah, guys, I have to replant all these potatoes right now. That's the one issue about the low farming skill, where everyone else is beating me right now. It's really unfortunate, but it isn't too hard to get it leveled up. And it's definitely worth it, because these potatoes, again, like I said, are gonna make me a ton of money. But guys, I am gonna go ahead and end off today's video right here. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys did enjoy it, make sure you leave a like and subscribe down below. And like I said, guys, come join the server. Use the IP, dazzer.oplegends.com, and you guys can get a free citizen rank here on the server. It's literally a free rank, so you might as well get it. The code for it is Dazzer. You do it at checkout. The store link is down below. Click the skyblock section, ranks, then citizen rank, add it to your cart, and then the discount code is just Dazzer. But guys, I am gonna go ahead and end off today's video here. I'll see you all in the next one, and until then, bye bye.